back again with another video. I hope you guys had a great Thanksgiving and a great holiday. So this video today is what to bring to quarantine and what not to bring. So we're gonna get into that, but I just want to say overall I want to thank everybody who watched my videos, who liked my videos, who subscribed. I really appreciate it. Like, it encouraged me to keep making more. And I make these videos because I was once searching it up. Like, I once needed help too, so I figure out why not. My mama in the background screaming. But yeah, so I just want to thank you guys for all the love. Keep subscribing, keep liking, keep asking questions, because I am here to help. So on that note, let's get into the video. So for quarantine, things have changed. Like, they no longer quarantine you at the Great Wolf Lodge Hotel or any other hotel. From my understanding, you're quarantined at the Army base in Wisconsin, I believe. I think so. But yeah, these motherfuckers. Anyway, I shipped out, I believe, July 24th or July 25th. So that was like 4 or 5 months ago. So things have changed. But I know what haven't changed is what to bring and what not to bring. It will always stay the same. No matter the location, it will always stay the same. So that's why I'm going to make this video. So when I shipped out, we was at Great Wolf Lodge. And we was there for 14 days. And let me tell you, I went crazy in that hotel. I went crazy. Like, after a while, I was like, okay, get me out of here. I just wanted to start booking at that point. But why at the hotel? Well, okay, I'm jumping the broom. Anyway, before you leave, talk to your recruiter. Ask him what you really need and what you really don't. My recruiter, honestly, I don't think he knew. That's why he gave me misunderstanding information. Because he told me, you're going to be quarantined, so I would bring clothes. So I brought like 4 days worth of clothes, and I should have never did that. I regret it. So you do not need clothes. Let me tell you that, baby. You don't need it. I didn't know that, so I brought like 4 days worth of clothes. I'm thinking I'm just about to be chilling at the hotel in my cities. No, that was not it. So off the bat, you do not need any clothes besides what you're wearing on your body when you leave. You do not need any clothes, any underwear. You don't need it, because all that will be provided. Don't make the mistake I made, because they was like, you can either trash it or keep it. And I wasn't trashing my clothes. Like, those are brand new clothes, and I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna keep it. It just make your sea bag heavier. You don't even need it. So what to bring and what not to bring. So, okay, I'm going to talk about my girls first. Girls, if you like put special oils in your hair, special grease, something, bring a little jar or something like that. Like, I encourage you to bring hair product, but let it be in like a small travel size bottle, because you don't want to bring anything crazy. They don't really make you trash your stuff. They just put all your stuff in a box, like a good sized box, not anything huge, just a little box. You put all your stuff in there that you brought that you don't really need, and they tape it up, and you don't get it until you graduate. So that's what they do. They don't ship your stuff home anymore. They don't trash it. Not really, they don't do that. So if you have any type of oils that you use for your hair, especially if you have dreads, you can bring that just in a little travel size, because you're A and B drawer, it isn't big at all. So that's that. And like, for me, ladies, you do get to wear makeup on picture day. So like, I brought my eyelashes glue, I brought me some Vicks, because this is my remedy right here. Brought like my foundation, concealer. I just brought like little makeup stuff, because I wanted to do my makeup on picture day. To be honest, you can even bring like a curling iron. This can fit in your A and B drawer if you like want to string your hair or curl in it. It do fit in your A and B drawer. Just don't bring a whole lot, because it won't fit, and you have to make it fit in your A and B drawer, or you have to trash it. So that is that. What else? Like, even if you don't bring it, you can have your parents or whoever, your loved ones, send stuff over there. Just make sure it's like, it's not food or anything. But if they send you like your homemade lotion or some shit like that, the RDC will open it. If it's like, if it's not food or anything harmful, then you can have it. So even if you don't bring it, you can still get it shipped to you. But don't bring anything crazy, because the A and B drawer is like this size, like this long, and like, okay, the width is like this, then the length is like this. It's not really deep or long, so it's just a compact drawer, and you have to make all your personal shit fit. So use it wisely. Don't bring a lot of clothes like God did, because I had to stuff all my civilian clothes in at the bottom of my sea bag when they would do inspections and stuff, because I was not trashing my shit. Other than that, ladies, you do not need to bring anything. Deodorant, toothbrush, nothing. Because all that will be provided to you besides the clothes on your body. Don't bring anything. Like, I would bring extra control, but other than that, don't bring anything else. You don't need it. My fellas, you can bring a hairbrush if you have waves. Combs and stuff, but all that, like, they sell brushes, edge control, they sell all that. No, they don't sell edge control at the next, my fault. But they sell brushes and hair products at the next, so even if you don't bring it, you can get it there. But you know, if it's like a special type of stuff that you use in your hair or whatever, you can bring it and stuff like that. But the reason I say don't bring any clothes or whatever you plan on bringing, I'm sorry, I'm losing my train of thought. Oh yeah, the reason I said don't bring it, because my clothes, since I didn't want to trash it, I had to carry all my civilian clothes, which made my sea bag heavier. So when we marched from ship one all the way to ship six, my sea bag was heavier than other people's because I had a lot of shit in there that I didn't even need. And I had it all through A school, and I finally brought it home. So don't be like me. Don't bring clothes that you don't need. Everything will be provided. You have toothbrush, all of that shit. So, yeah. I'm thinking, y'all. Oh, yeah. So, they'll provide you with a lock. And that's the lock that go in your A&B drawer. Make sure you always lock your A&B drawer, because that's your personal stuff. They don't really have permission to go in there unless it's necessary. But if it's not locked, it's open, so anybody can go in there, and you don't even want nobody stealing your stuff, so just make sure your shit is locked, you know. Ladies, for hair, I know people have been asking me about hair, about dreads and stuff. You can have braids. Like, you see how my braids are right now? You can have this and go to boot camp. I did not know that until the night before I was about to leave. I was like, what the fuck? Because I did have braids, but it was like a little bit bigger than this. And wait, hold up, let me get my cover and show you guys that it does fit with the cover. So here's my cover. I really don't want to take my hair down, but I think I can still wear it on top. See, shit, see, my cover can still fit, and it's in like a low ponytail. So if you have braids this size, it's perfect, because it can go in a bun and everything. You can wrap it up. It's really perfect. But braids this size is acceptable. You just have to put it in a little bun like this, so you can have individual. If it's this size, it could be a little bit bigger, just nothing huge. Just a little bit bigger than this, but I feel like this is a perfect size. I wish I would have took these into boot camp. If you have dreads, that's fine, that's cool. It just have to be lengthwise. If it's short, if it is longer, that's fine. You just gotta be able to put it in a neat bun. Same with long weave. If you have anything longer than a bob, you gotta be able to put in a low, neat, slick bun. If you do have a bob, it just has to stop at the, I think at the bottom of your collar. Yeah. Basically that's it. I'm thinking, like, I know this video is really short. I'm sorry, guys. I'm really trying to help you guys out, but like, I've been losing my train of thought. Like, I'm really trying to be helpful. But yeah, as I said in my other video, a couple of advice I have for everybody that's about to ship off to boot camp: know how to swim. And if you know how to swim, great, that's perfect. But don't be like me. I went there not knowing how to swim, and it was not pretty. Like, I was drowning shit. So know how to swim. You really need that. Know how to run or know how to control your breathing when you run. I don't know. Because some people know how to run, but they just can't control their breathing. And then they get out of breath too fast. So know how to run and know how to control your breathing while you run. Study your trainee guide, your student guide, whatever they call it. Study and know your ranks and recognition. Socialize. Don't just be there stuck up thinking like, okay, I'm just going in and out. Like, you're going to have to socialize because that's the way you get through it all. But for those who's about to ship off, like, I really wish you guys the best. I hope you go very far in your military career. That's basically it. Like, overall, you don't need anything. You don't need to bring anything to quarantine besides your state ID, social security card. You can bring at least $10. You can bring more, but don't bring a lot of money. It might get, you might get robbed. Not robbed, but somebody might steal it. So you don't really need a lot of money. You can bring your debit card, but they're gonna ask you if you wanna set up a Navy Federal account or Armed Forces account. So you can set up a whole new bank account over there. So you don't really have to bring your bank card. And bring you, like, the clothes you're wearing. You can bring a little backpack for, like, I don't know, snacks and stuff, but you really don't even need that. Like, just bring you, your phone, your social security, your ID, and a little bit of cash for real. That's all you really need. If you wear glasses, bring your glasses. Do not bring any firearms. Don't bring vapes, because vapes, they will make you trash. You will trash your vapes. Electronics, they're gonna box it up too. You can bring a Game Boy, but they don't let you use it at the hotel, not even at the hotel. So there's really no point in bringing it, so don't bring that. But any electronics you bring, like an Apple Watch or whatever, it's still gonna get boxed up. You cannot wear it at quarantine or boot camp. It's not gonna fly. Social security, state ID, a little bit of cash. You can bring a little book or a Bible, just something travel size if you want to. That's optional. That's basically it. Don't bring no extra shit because you won't need it. Don't bring vape. They're going to make you trash it. Nail polish. My mom brought me, like, my mom sent me clear nail polish and I was allowed to wear it. Like, it was clear. It blended with my skin. You can't have these. Like, these. You're gonna have to take it off if you do. So I wouldn't even go in wearing it. Because I don't know, for some reason they'd be like, when you're going to the pool, when you're about to go swim, they'd be like, if you have any nail polish or fake nails, remove it. I don't know why, but I guess they don't want to go into the pool and get in the pool all clogged up, whatever. So ladies, if you have fake nails, take it off because it's not gonna fly. Yeah, things are at the next. So say you forgot something, you can go to the next and get it. They might not have everything. So even if the next don't have something you want, you can get your parents or your loved ones to send you stuff. as long as it's not food or anything crazy, though, you can have it. Yeah, that's basically it. So thank you guys for watching. I know this video is really short, but I was just trying to give you guys idea of what to bring and what not to bring. Don't bring no sex toys. Some boy did that. That shit was stupid. Don't do that. Don't do that. Oh my god, people are crazy. But yeah, that's basically it. Like and subscribe if you have any questions, comments, something I missed, something that I didn't talk about. Comment below. I'm here. But thank you guys. It's Team V. Bye.